Today's visit begins here in Adventureland, where the Indiana Jones adventure finally reopened back on March 17th. It definitely was great walking through this queue again after its 3-month refurbishment.
One.
Bringing much-needed vibrancy back to this section of the park.
Here are special belts attached into the seats. Simply pull it from the right, inserting it into the left, like so. You see the excellence of this invention? Your off-road journey is high-speed and turbulent, going over rough and rugged terrain, and then suddenly you are turning sharply and dropping suddenly. It is unlike anything you have ever experienced, I assure you. Now,
every aspect of this attraction got refreshed in some way.
The brakes may be needing a little adjustment. Easy on the curves.
You have chosen time. This path leads to timeless
effects, which were non-operational, were brought back to working order.
There's so much you can't possibly comprehend. Quick, take a look. It's the only way out. Nice driving.
One in particular is this large animatronic snake.
Snakes? You guys are all wrong.
And this new upcoming scene replaced the projected ride effect.
That wasn't big fun.
Overall, it was great seeing this world-famous attraction getting revamped like this. Up on the Disneyland app is this full map of Mickey's Toontown after its official reopening back on March 19th. But today, however, was the first for yours truly to walk through it himself. And the first sight to greet me in this reimagined land is this new Mickey and Minnie Fountain at the edge of Centennial Park. There is a lot more to explore here, so let's begin over at Chip and Dale's Gadget Coaster. This roller coaster is pretty much the same as it was before, with the exception of Chip, Zipper, and Dale making appearances in its queue. And for the first time, Gadget Hat Wrench is present too.
Okay, I tested everything myself and she's ship shape.
I guess I really mean she's coaster shape.
Next door is Donald's boat. The boat that surrounded it is now completely filled in. No longer offering interior and or deck access. Appearing in this vessel's portholes are these figures from the 2017 DuckTales. Totally surprising that they were dimensional and practical. Goofy's How to Play a Yard is designed for kids of all ages and abilities, providing such with brand new play opportunities. Like this musical bridge, for example. But inside, the house itself is a candy kitchen. This contraption, hide within it, captures honey leaking from a beehive. With interactive elements, popping, rolling, and whizzing throughout. The next attraction that reopened in Toontown was Roger Rabbit's Cartoon Spin. No major changes were made during its year-long refurbishment.
This is a respectable club, so if you ain't got the dough, bro. Oh, dig it. There's a rabbit business. You don't take no visitors.
We interrupt this program to bring you this special news report.
Oh, come on!
Those bad guy hoodlum weasels are at it again.
The weasels? Not those guys again!
Causing dastardly destruction with their fatal mixture of dip, that terrible green liquid of destruction.
Dip? That's a load of succotash!
I repeat.
Each of its effects and animatronics, both in the queue and on the ride itself, are in proper working order again.
Yeah!
the rest of Toontown now open, it's easy to see how Runaway Railway fits in with the rest of it. Of course, to get the full experience of Mickey's Toontown, I decided to view a screening at the El Capitan Theater.
See you all later.
Nothing can stop us now. I don't know how. I've had any trouble.
Take a ride on the train? Excuse me, you later.
Who, me?
Do you mind helping these good people into the cartoon while I fix this here hokey pokey?
Sure, Goofy, I'll send them into the whole new world.
Thanks, we'll be back in a jiffy to pick you all up.
Well, that ending was a blast, wasn't it?
Yeah.
All right, I'll have you guys come on into the cartoon. I'll just follow right behind you to make sure that it's safe for me.
What Disney attraction would not be complete without an exit into a gift shop? Such as this one here, which finally opened as well. Locomotion seems to be the working theme in this store, since a model can be seen circling the track above. Filled with great merchandise for sale, including this remote-controlled Mickey Mouse Roadster and trackless locomotive. In Tomorrowland, a fascinating development has occurred over at Space Mountain. Where the single rider option has returned. A little different route this time around. But a welcome modification nonetheless.
You're clear to watch.
Nice seeing Single Rider Line back after Genie Plus debuted last year. It was also recently announced that Hyperspace Mountain will be returning for a Star Wars celebration later this May. So, the next time you desire to race through the cosmos on the dark edge of the galaxy, be sure to do that during your next visit to the resort.
Thank you.